Choosing the wrong type of wire in a mobile, marine, or off-grid electrical system can have catastrophic results. Learning the differences between the various types of wires is exactly what I'm going to teach you here in lesson number one of this Wire Basics playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Before we get started, I put some important information about this academy, some additional resources, and some prerequisite information related to this video down in the pinned comment below. So be sure to scroll down and check it out. Let's get started. Can off-grid electrical systems be wired with home improvement store wire? Now, if you're brand new to off-grid electrical systems, you may be tempted to just go to Home Depot, Lowe's, or Ace Hardware and get your wiring there. But here's why that might be a mistake. Those stores are stocked with home improvement products, which means that they don't carry the best wire sizes and types for a successful DC-based low-voltage off-grid electrical system, much less the proper wires for an installation subject to the vibrations of a mobile installation like a boat or RV. Now, if you're building an off-grid cabin, you can most definitely use those home improvement stores for the standard 120, 240 volt wiring throughout the cabin coming from the breaker box, but stick with me and I'll teach you about better alternatives for the rest of the system. How does wire insulation affect wire choice? 6-gauge THHN wire from your home improvement store has a maximum amp rating of 75 amps. And the 6-gauge battery wire that we sell in our store has a maximum amp rating of 120 amps. But why? They're both high quality wire, but different types of wire have different types of insulation. And the different types of insulation on the outside sometimes allow for higher amp ratings due to the heat they can withstand. THHN wire has 75 degrees Celsius insulation, while our battery wire has 105 degrees Celsius insulation. Now this means that the higher rated insulation on this wire can get just a little bit hotter on the inside before it starts breaking down, which means that it can safely carry a few more amps. Now this is why you actually see in some of our wiring kits 6-gauge wire protected with a 100 amp fuse. Now, although the temperature ratings of wire is the most important consideration, various insulations have other properties that make them more appropriate than others for various use cases. The solar wire that we have in our store has a special UV-resistant coating on the outside of the insulation since it's going to be exposed to sunlight. And some other wires that I don't have on my table here are rated for direct burial underground. Now, speaker wire in general isn't really rated to carry amps necessarily. Instead, from what I found, it's based largely on the ohms of the speaker and shouldn't really be used to wire off-grid electrical components together. Now, in fact, I've actually stumbled across some 4-aught speaker wire on Amazon, which is about the same size as this, so it's really big, but it claims to be for 700 amps, which is nearly double what is allowed per the American Boat and Yacht Council. So, yeah, I'm just sort of weary of speaker wire for non-speaker applications. Now, maybe you can push 700 amps with 4-aught wire in a high-powered speaker, subwoofer, or amplifier, you know, car audio type of system. I don't know. That's not really my realm. But 700 amps for things like inverters, solar charge controllers, and such for off-grid power applications like we talk about on this channel would be way too much for 4-aught wire.
You're not wiring the speaker, wiring
the
speaker wire.
Yeah. How do voltage ratings work in wire? So in general, wire is rated for its intended purpose. For example, the SGR battery wire that we have in our battery bank wiring kits includes wire that is rated for up to 600 volts. Now, since battery banks rarely, or maybe never, exceed 600 volts, it makes sense that the manufacturer of battery wire would choose the proper rating for its intended purpose. Our solar wire, on the other hand, is rated for 1,000 volts, which makes sense because we have solar charge controllers in our store rated to handle up to 250 volts, And Victron makes solar charge controllers rated up to 450 volts for much larger arrays. And Morningstar, they make them for ratings up to 600 volts. So it makes sense why solar wire is rated for such a high voltage rating. The voltage rating for each wire can always be found stamped directly onto the side of the wire itself. And it's a maximum voltage rating. So if you had some 12 volt puck lights that you needed to hook up, so as long as the voltage rating of the wire is larger than 12, you're good to go as far as the voltage is concerned. What's the difference between solid and stranded wire? Now, in a house, there is Romex running all throughout the walls. Romex is just a bundle of three or more wires in an outer sheath, and in gauges 10 gauge and smaller, these are solid wires, just, you know, one solid piece of copper per wire. Now, stranded wires, on the other hand, serve a similar purpose, but instead of one solid wire, like in Romex, it's made up of a bunch of way smaller wires. What are the pros and cons of solid versus stranded wire? Solid wire is less expensive than stranded wire. And stranded wire, being made up of bundles of much smaller wires, is significantly more flexible than solid wire, meaning it's much easier to work with. Stranded wire is also not as prone to work hardening and breaking like solid core wire is. Now, when solid core wire is subjected to repeated bending, movement, and vibrations, over time, it's going to wear out and break. And when it breaks, the insulation will slightly, you know, hold it together, and the break will cause a mass amounts of resistance and heat, which could potentially start a fire. Now, in a house or stationary application, this is not really a consideration because houses are not subject to regular movement or vibrations like boats or RVs are. Now, this risk is so great that the American Boat and Yacht Council specifically forbids solid core wire in marine applications. So why do we still see solid core wire in use in off-the-lot RVs? Well, since Romex is the cheapest option, RV manufacturers are incentivized to keep things as, you know, inexpensive as possible. And when a wire bends, breaks, and catches on fire, the occupant can hopefully just step outside, step away, and call their insurance agent. And this is not something that can happen in marine applications because stepping off the side of a boat to avoid a fire introduces a whole new set of hazards, one of which could be sharks. So if you want to build your mobile or marine off-grid electrical system to have the least chance of catching on fire, opt for stranded wire in 100% of use cases. Now, if you're building an off-grid cabin that isn't subjected to the vibrations of the sea or the road, solid core wire like Romex for all the small branch circuits, leaving the breaker box is just fine. For all the larger wire on the DC side of the system, that should still be stranded wire for the sake of workability. The last consideration of solid versus stranded wire is workability. Now, with small 12 gauge stranded wire versus small 12 gauge solid, there's a pretty obvious difference in how easy the wire is to work with and make it go to where we need it to go. But not all stranded wire is the same, so we need to talk about strand counts. Why are the strand counts of a wire important? The number of strands found in a wire is important for wire flexibility, especially as the wire gauge gets larger and larger. Now, this is 4-aught wire, which is the largest wire we have available in our store. And even as big as it is, it's still pretty flexible. Now, next time you're at your local home improvement store, head over to the wire aisle and grab a piece of 4-aught stranded wire that has, you know, let's call it 5 to 10 strands in it, and let me know how hard it is to bend. Spoiler alert, it's pretty much like a piece of rebar. It doesn't bend very well at all. Now, this same concept can be seen in, you know, 6-gauge battery wire that we sell in our store versus the 6-gauge THHN wire that I picked up from Ace Hardware. Notice how many strands of wire are in each one. There's about 19 strands or so in this THHN wire, and there's about 266 or so strands in our 6-gauge battery wire over here. What is the difference between copper and aluminum wire? Aluminum wire used to be widely common, but has been replaced with copper wiring starting back in the 1970s. Aluminum was used because, although it can only carry about 60% of the amps as copper for the same physical dimension, aluminum is also generally about 30% of the cost of copper, historically. So it usually was cheaper, even though the wire had to be bigger. Now, for this reason, you'll still see aluminum wiring in really big wires with long runs from, let's say, a power line transformer to a house, for example. But for pretty much everything else, copper is the standard nowadays. Now, there are all kinds of problems with aluminum wiring that we're not going to get into since it's really no longer common, but the aluminum building wire Wikipedia page actually has all kinds of really cool info on it if you're interested, and if you're a nerd.
Thank you.
Like me. What is tinned wire? Now, I've seen a lot of people post about high-quality marine wire and say that it's aluminum wire, and that's simply not true. You know, tinned copper wire and aluminum wire, even though they're about the same color, they're not the same. Tinned copper wire is simply copper wire that has a very thin coating of tin on each strand. And tin is more corrosion resistant than copper, so in areas where corrosion is a hazard, like on a boat in the salty ocean, tinned copper wire can help slow corrosion because of the salt in the air, but it doesn't really affect its electrical properties too much. In most of the wiring kits in our shop, as of making this video, June 5th, 2024, we sell untinned copper wire. And here's why. With our historical focus in RVs and vans, there's really no need for the additional expense of tinned copper in a land-based application. In most vehicles, all of the factory wiring is untinned, and we don't really feel that it's worth passing on an additional expense to our customers for little to no added benefit. But with our recent rebranding to include marine applications, we do plan on adding tinned versions of our wiring kits to our store in 2025 when we move to a bigger warehouse. For those of you looking for seaworthy electrical systems, so stay tuned. What are the different safety certifications of wire? Now, every wire is going to have some kind of safety certification either stamped directly onto it or included on the manufacturer's product page. If it doesn't have any SAE, UL, ROHS, ASTM, ISO, or ID10T ratings, it should probably not be used. Safety ratings and certifications are a pretty deep rabbit hole here because in addition to simply having the rating or certification, having the proper rating for the intended use is equally important. I asked Steph to pull some certifications and ratings that some of the various wires in our store have, and in about 3 minutes, she had all of these put together before I told her I didn't need any more. So be sure that your wire has certifications and safety ratings. And then make sure that those certifications and ratings are appropriate for your intended purposes. Or just buy your wiring kits from shop.explorist.life, where we've already done the legwork for you. Now you should have a good idea of the different types of wires used in a mobile, marine, or off-grid electrical system. And we're going to be referring back to this video throughout the rest of this academy as we talk about how to wire various components. So be sure to bookmark it for future reference and come back to it if you need a refresher. Now before we move on to the next lesson, let me know the biggest wiring mistake that you've ever made in the comment section below so we can all learn from each other's mistakes. Now in the next lesson, I'm going to teach you everything that you need to know about wire sizes and gauges. So click up here to watch and I'll see you over there. Copper MS, was it ASMR? AMRSM? What is the difference between copper and aluminum wire? One's copper and one's aluminum. Next chapter, moving on. What is tinned wire? What is tinned wire? What is tinned wire? What is tinned wire? What is tinned wire?